A ground-penetrating radar, the latest tool in the search for the remains of William Tyrrell. Police examined the concrete slab in the garage of the home where the three-year-old was last seen. They cleared it of holding sinister secrets, but digging for clues has also dug up old wounds.
Whenever there's a breakthrough, I'm always excited, but the way it's playing out very publicly, is a bit strange.
Formerly Detective Gary Jubelin doggedly pursued the theory William was abducted, but now police believe he may have fallen 5 metres to his death from the balcony of his foster grandmother's home and was then transported in her grey Mazda to this area less than a kilometre away to be buried. William's mother is now a key person of interest to police, but Jubelin, who led the investigation for 4 years, says that theory just doesn't stack up.
There was absolutely no evidence that made me suspicious in regards to their involvement.
He says he thoroughly investigated the 56-year-old, including using listening devices in the family car.
My impression is that she's a very decent human being. And I certainly, whenever I'm dealing with victims, and this is the detective in me, that I'm always looking out for something suspicious. And I've got to say, I have not picked up any of that.
She told Leah Harris in an exclusive interview for the 10 News First podcast, Where is William Tyrrell, that Jubelin being taken off her son's case destroyed her faith in New South Wales police.
I don't trust police. I can't. Based on what they're doing with William's case, can't. Because we're being lied to.
The man who took over the case from Jubelin, Detective Chief Inspector David Laidlaw, is not backing down. He's confident he is right and Jubelin is wrong. And he's got support from the very top.
And I want to say thank you to them for never giving up on this case.
The Prime Minister among those hoping this fresh lead brings answers.
I hope these latest developments provide them with some comfort.
Well, Steve is live from Kendall now. Steve, where will police focus their search efforts tomorrow?
Yes, good evening, Sandra. They will continue to focus the search right here at this bushland behind us. They've laid down a whole heap of tarpaulin to protect the area. They've also put up some gazebos as well to protect the area as much as they can. It did look like there might be some wind and rain around tonight. That's cleared up a little bit at the moment here, but of course this will continue to be the area. They already found those two pieces of string yesterday that have been sent away to be tested. We'll be waiting for the results of that to come back. That may take a couple of weeks, along with the luminol testing from the home and testing from the car as well that they see. So still a fair bit of work to go, and as we said at the top, the continuing search here tomorrow, it'll be bright and early, Sandra.